Okay, welcome back for the finals with my pretty sweet blue red surge draft deck. I'm on the draw with a pretty borderline hand. I mean, I do have lands and spells. I can try to trade off with my Umara Entangler and then Containment Membrane my opponent's next threat and just draw out of this unexciting hand. These Surge kind of decks, they don't do great when they're mana flooded. And I don't have any of my best cards in this hand. It's pretty rare that I mulligan a, you know, 5-land, 2-spell hand in limited when I have both my colors. But this might be a case where I can just do better. I think this is pretty borderline. I'm going to mulligan this time. I don't know what's right, though. This hand is a little better, especially if I can scry a land to the top. Well, I feel kind of bad scrying that to the bottom, but it's really just not what I need right now. Perfect. Okay. Coming out fast. I am coming out slow. Wow. Bringing in the boiling earth for next game. So I think the move here is I want to play Maw of Kozilek, and then next turn I can go Archive Boulder Salvo, one of the flyers. My opponent missed one land drop, so, well, there you go. Now that's the worst case scenario, when your opponent misses one land drop and then hits, because then it's like, okay, they have a handful of spells, and now they can cast them. Well, I think I want to cast Storm Chaser Mage and Boulder Salvo, one of the Sky Spawners. I guess before anything else, I should declare my attack step, and don't imagine my opponent's going to tap the Maw, but maybe. Actually, maybe I should Boulder Salvo the Blinding Drone. That's actually a tough call because Blinding Drone is a better creature than the Sky Spawners, but if I play Storm Chaser Mage and my opponent just has a removal spell for it, the Sky Spawners are going to kill me pretty quickly. But I have three Reality Hemorrhages that can kill the Sky Spawners and not as many ways to kill Blinding Drone. Well, I guess that made my decision a little easier. I really just have to get one of these flyers off the table and buy myself some more time. Okay. Not the most exciting turn in the world, but maybe I'll draw Serpentine Spike or something that I can spend all this hundreds of mana on. So So this puts me to 2, meaning that just as a basic step 1 to not die, I need to find an answer to the Sky Spawner. This game's definitely looking pretty bad for me. Wow. That... Speak of the devil and he shall appear. Alright, so I get to kill 1, 2, 3 creatures and then have a blocker for the translator and maybe I have a chance in this game. 2 damage, 3 damage, 4 damage. Let me think about actually what lands I want to have untapped. I have 10 mana, so I just get to have Wandering Femoral untapped, which sure, that's fine. Ouch. That's bad. Now I lose. Seems like I want to bring in some counter spells of my own to fight back a little bit. Boiling Earth, I'd mentioned, for this double Sky Spawner. And what's not good? Don't think I want any defensive ground creatures, really. Kozilek Sentinel. Bring in 1 negate for now. And we'll bring Kozilek Sentinel back in. Reevaluate for game 3. Choose to draw like I've been doing. This hand's really good. So I'm going to get hit in the air, I'm going to get ingested a little bit, but I do have 3 reality hemorrhages to be able to deal with these little annoying little 2 toughness guys. Wow, lots of annoying little 2 toughness guys. I actually can't cast anything this turn, so I just have to say go. Thankfully, my opponent doesn't have any colorless mana yet, so any damage that I'm taking is just damage to my life total that could be undone. My opponent's not actually getting card advantage from these guys just yet. So I want to get my Hedron Archive in play. And I don't want to run the Serpentine Spike into open mana, but if my opponent ever taps out, that's a pretty powerful game-changing, game-swinging effect that I can have access to. Both my counterspells are gone, so I'm at my opponent's mercy now. But So for sure, casting Serpentine Spike. Let me just decide what my priorities are to kill. Definitely killing Mind Melter and Blinding Drone, and I think I have to kill a Prophet of Distortion. Let the Mist Intruder live for now. So, 2, 3, 4. So I'm not sure at what point I have to just cast the Dark Dwellers for no value. Let me see once again what exactly I have to flash back. Expedite, 3 Reality Hemorrhages, but one is gone, and a Boiling Earth that I sideboarded in, but Boiling Earth's not even that good. I think maybe I should just put the Dark Dwellers into play. Now I get to have a little bit of a stable board and hopefully just win with my man land, my Hedron Archive, my 2 spells left in hand. Definitely trading off. Access to 9 mana here, 10 counting the Scion, but don't really want to count the Scion. Why don't I start by cracking the Archive? I think I'm going to do that soon anyway. Just Boulder Salvo on Gravity Negator. Continue biding my time. So, not sure what the last card my opponent could have in hand. Could be a land, could be a counterspell, and he or she is just tapped out every turn so far. No, I doubt it's a counterspell. Oh, well, at least I can double burn that, but that is a card that's pretty hard for my deck to beat, and I'm not looking forward to having to play against that in the next 2 games. Alright, first things first, I think I want to just cast Expedite on something. So, Expedite. Okay. Now, Surge or Boulder Salvo. Cast a Reality Hemorrhage. No profitable attacks for me right now, so I'll say go again. Now that I know about that Endbringer, what I can definitely do is switch my Negate for a Void Shatter for Game 3. Still no great attacks. looking to draw a flying creature, another Hedron Archive, the Jory N. Boiling Earth, and then I can cast it with Awaken. Huh. I'm at 8. At what point do I Boulder Salvo the Sky Spawner? I think maybe I can take a hit and then Containment Membrane it. Come on, Jory N. Storm Chaser Mage, decent. Got my one power flying attacker that I can just keep chipping away with till further notice. Really hope my opponent doesn't have any raise dead effects to get the Endbringer back, because that's a card that I cannot beat if it gets back into play. Intentionally playing out my lands to so that I wouldn't lose them to a Mind Rot, but Mind Raker makes my play look kind of silly. Sure. There we go. I think I just want to crack it right away. Although maybe not. Maybe I'll wait till the end of the turn. Just in case something crazy happens, I need to activate Wandering Fumarole. Or if I activate it now, I draw something good. My opponent has a Mind Rot. That's pretty bad as well. So I think there are a couple of reasons to wait and activate at the end of the turn. Unfortunately, this is getting so deep in the game that Jory N is not even that exciting. I only have 13 cards left in my library, and a decently large number of them are just lands. Hopefully Storm Chaser Mage can go all the way. Okay, those are good draws. Well, I'm going to cast them pre-combat in case I find something to cast to trigger Prowess. Wow, I actually won. I don't think my opponent should have conceded. I didn't have that much left in my library. Okay, so Void Shatter's coming in. I need every possible way to have a chance against Endbringer that I can find. Abstruse Interference is a card I would actually consider when I really desperately need an answer to something. However, I already have 2-3 mana counters that are much better, and my opponent having Eldrazi Scions make you not very vulnerable to force spike effects, because, you know, they usually just have an extra mana kicking around. So what to cut? Maybe this Immobilizer Eldrazi is better than I'm thinking. I don't have a lot of hope of getting through on the ground, but my opponent, like, almost every creature had high toughness. Like, Cultivator Drone, Blinding Drone, Kozlex Translator, all that stuff. Alright, and what do I want to cut? Maybe it's still just the worst card that I have access to. Maybe Ruin Processor's not that good. Yeah. No, I kind of like it. I'm bringing in extra way to exile as well. All right, I'll try this. Last game of the draft. We really love a 3-0 here. I think in the absence of that Endbringer, my deck matches up pretty well here. So if I can just be careful not to let that get into play, I feel all right about my chances. This hand is not very exciting. My mana curve's really high. If I don't hit my third land, it's just going to be over. If I do hit my third land, then I can hope that my opponent doesn't have a fast start. But my opponent just goes 2-drop Eldrazi Skyspawner. Things are going to get kind of ugly, kind of fast. That said, I don't know if it's bad enough that I can afford to go to 6. So say I hit one land in my top 3. It's quite unlikely to brick 3 times on land, although it could happen. And if I hit my fourth land, then I can keep my mana open and then cast a divination at the end of the turn. I think it's worth keeping. I hope that it's not just a slaughter, non-competitive game. Well, so far so good. So far so good. Wow, so far so good. Now I actually feel like my hand's great. This is a great time to cast Hedron Archive because I would really love to hang on to the Void Shatter as an answer to Endbringer, and my opponent can't cast Endbringer this turn. So now I could consider just slamming Ruin Processor. It's not even that good against Blinding Drone, and I don't want my opponent to get the Endbringer in play. So I'll try to play the game in a way where I get to keep 3 mana open for as long as possible. It's not that bad since I get to progress my game plan by casting Comparative Analysis at the end of the turn anyway. Good draws. I got some good stuff to work with here. Problem is, put myself in a pickle by using the Spell Shrivel when maybe I should have used the Void Shatter instead. Now I can't really tap any blue mana if I want to keep playing around Endbringer. Also, I have 8 mana now. If I have 9, then I can just double burn the Endbringer in a pinch. So therefore, I could see playing Sky Spawner and then Dwar Isle Avenger. And then if my opponent gets Endbringer into play, I can go Serpentine Spike, use my Eldrazi Scion to Boulder Salvo the Endbringer. And it's not a very efficient answer, but I feel like I'm pretty far ahead in this game and just need to basically not lose to that one card. Alternatively, I could just Boulder Salvo the Blinding Drone and pass. Not excited about that because Blinding Drone's a really good target if I ever get to resolve the Serpentine Spike. Also, let's keep in mind my opponent is very likely to have counter spells of his or her own. Tough to know what to do here. Maybe I just bide my time. basically deciding between saying a land, playing a land and saying go, or casting my two flyers. I think I'll cast my two flyers. I'm out of lands, and I'm going to have to be discarding to hand size soon, so I don't really want to get in a total stalemate. Now I can wait. Now I can wait around. If I get 10 mana, then I could Serpentine Spike and protect it with Void Shatter. That's a good way to end the game. If I get another mana, I can just cast Ruin Processor too and still have Void Shatter. But name of the game is Patience and just not leaving myself vulnerable to anything crazy, since I feel like I'm pretty far ahead right now. That is my 10th mana. Letting me attack. Alright. Trading off's a good play for my opponent there, because it reduces the impact of Serpentine Spike if I'm ever able to cast it. Now, another card I'm thinking about in this game is Spell Shrivel. At this point, I have 11 mana, and I can sort of play the game in a way where my opponent never gets to Spell Shrivel anything. At this point, I have 10 mana and 7 mana cards in my hand, so it seems wasteful to cast something here on the last turn where Spell Shrivel is actually going to be an effective card against me. That's going to let my opponent draw two, but I still think I want to save the Void Shatter for something more impactful. Deciding what to do here. Maybe this is the turn where I cast Ruin Processor plus Boulder Salvo. Or maybe I go Storm Chaser Mage plus Boulder Salvo. No, I think I like Ruin Processor. Sure. Guess I'm a little vulnerable to Endbringer now. But the game is... I can probably end the game in a relatively quick time frame, so as to not just be like completely dead in the water against Endbringer. So Serpentine Spike looks pretty good here. How much mana do I have? 10, 11, counting the Scion. So, first I'm going to declare my attack. See if my opponent lets me come in. Probably will tap Ruin Processor. Now I guess I'll just Serpentine Spike the three creatures that I can kill. And pass with Void Shatter mana. Two, three, four. That is good enough to want to Void Shatter. All right. So 3-0 with blue-red Surge. Blue-red Rares, we can call it. I liked that deck a lot. I think Hedron Archive is just a really, really unfair card. When you have a deck that can actually use the mana. And, this was pretty nice, like, great removal, solid mana curve, good late game. I would be happy to have this deck every time. I hope you had fun watching the draft. I had fun playing, and tune in again next time. Thanks.